has asked for some mic time before that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jesse Neal has asked for some mic time.
Truths to lay down on you guys. Some of you might not like it, but a lot of you will understand why. And I asked Frank to come out too because he's everything to this company. If Frank wasn't here, give it up to him. If Frank wasn't a part of USWA, there would be no USWA, and there would be no Jesse Neal in USWA. Frank, and the reason why I asked for this time is because this is officially my last appearance in USWA. This is not part of the show, it's not part of the storylines, it's legit. I have a beautiful family I'm trying to be there for, and just, I got a couple of projects coming up that's gonna take too much of my time, and I have to move on. I've been wrestling in front of you guys for 7 years now. A lot of you guys I've seen over the years, you guys seen me grow, and I just wanna thank you with everything I have, because if it wasn't for you guys, there would be no Jesse Neal. And from the bottom of my heart,
your pretty little wife, and your great family.
You shut up when Frankie's talking!
Do you think the symbol of disrespect? Do you think the symbol of disrespect gives a hot damn about your kid about to be born?
There's one thing you don't do with me now, is talk my child, because I will come out of this ring and rip your my last appearance. I will take anybody in the back to take those belts from anybody.
Things are getting very, very personal here in USWA. We saw the circle of disrespect. We just saw them truly living up to their name, disrespecting Jesse Neal. Things are getting very hot and heavy here.
Yeah, We're sorry the technical difficulties came up and stuff, but there were a few words that you just couldn't air on Pro Wrestling Extra, and he's obviously emotional. He's been talking about, you know, quitting or, you know, some sort of retirement of some sort, but, you know, we'll have to find out, you know. But right now, he wants his hands on the COD, you know, pretty bad.
He's going to get his hands on the COD, but not quite yet. Frank Howell said he's going to make that match for the tag team titles, but first we've got a junior heavyweight title, big three-way. You got Blain Rage defending his title against Mike Cruz and Tim Zbyszko. Big three-way dance action. Let's take it to the ring.
For those of you too ignorant to know, I am the greatest managerial force in the history of professional wrestling, and you have no choice but to hear my voice because showing some respect. You may notice that Shooter Storm is not by my side tonight. And I'll tell you why. Because he was sick and tired of being treated the way he was treated at this promotion by every single one of you, by Frank Howell in the back. And he had enough. He packed up everything he owned and he moved to New York. But don't think that you've gotten rid of me so easily. I am still here, and tonight, history will be made.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Plainsville, Florida. He is the United States Wrestling Alliance Junior Heavyweight Champion, Blain Rage.
Set for junior heavyweight title action here as we've got a three-way matchup. The champion Blain Rage being challenged by Mike Cruz and Tim Zbyszko.
Can you believe the attitude change of Tim Zbyszko? Hiring Justin Michaels.
Justin Michaels to be his new advisor here. Yeah, turning his back on the fans who have been right there with him in his tag matches. Rocky Santiago supporting the second generation superstar. He is absolutely spit in the face of everyone here in USWA.
Totally berating the fans and Rocky.
Regardless of his words, I mean, we've got a very, very interesting matchup here. This is a three-way dance. Whoa, look out. And a Blain Rage and Mike going right after Mike Cruz. I was about to say, Blain Rage and Mike Cruz are the ones who have a big history here.
Absolutely.
And you said Tim Zbyszko wants nothing to do with either one of them. He's just looking for the title here, but I just have to say, Blain Rage going after Mike Cruz, because Mike Cruz has been the one stealing his title belt, backstabbing him at every corner. I mean, doing everything he can to get under the skin of Blain Rage. And finally, he's going to look to put away both these men.
Yeah, I mean, even though I don't like exactly what Tim Zbyszko did, it obviously helped him out, because look, he's in a title match.
He's in a title match here. Junior heavyweight title match, the champion, Blain Rage. He's going to look to retain that belt here, but ladies and gentlemen, with the three-way matchup, anybody can win this match. This is one fall to a finish. Ooh, Blain Rage has got to be careful here, as he can lose the title without even being involved in the finish.
Yep, he's sending both of them out to the ring. Oh, did he hit his head on?
Man, Mike Cruz hit his head on the outside there. Rage is able to handle both men. As we saw him going right after Mike Cruz in their history, but now
a shoving match going on.
This is Mike Cruz going at
Blain Rage.
Rage up and over the top, Paycon Hilo.
Wow, they're preoccupied with, you know, each other out there. They didn't
each
see
other and
over.
Their egos just clashing on the outside, and Blain Rage took advantage.
Justin Michaels looking on at his new protege.
Absolutely, the Bush Justin Michaels.
and his new apprentice, so to speak, Tim Zbyszko. Maybe see something in the new attitude of the second generation star. PWI's Rookie of the Year, by the way, as he likes to tell everyone he meets.
Yeah. Now, Justin Michaels is a great manager, I'll give him that. He knows how to scout people.
Here we go, folks. We've got Mike Cruz and Blain Rage toe-to-toe here in the middle, and Blain wants every piece of Mike Cruz, who has just been a thorn in his side almost from day one here in USWA.
Yeah, their last match together was a phenomenal matchup.
See, fantastic matchup, and we've seen Mike Cruz do some dastardly deeds, jumping Blain Rage from behind, stealing his title belt at one point. Blain Rage obviously able to get it back. He had it coming out here, but that belt is on the line, and Mike Cruz wants it legitimately this time.
Is him taking his time out there?
He has every right to take a breather out there. He can't be counted out, but he needs to keep an eye on these two as he can lose his matchup from the outside.
Yeah, there it goes. Title, get the title.
Absolutely. One does Rage fall to a finish. But yeah, again, he may be just waiting for the opportunity to strike him. Man, he's just going to go right after Mike Cruz.
Oh, wow.
This is a junior heavyweight title matchup. Tim Zbyszko, a little bit bigger than both of the men, obviously has a height advantage here. And I guess he's going to try to use it. Just that this powerhouse just clubbed right to the back of the smaller Mike Cruz.
Being a second generation superstar, I mean, he's got the knowledge and
Larry Zbyszko, I mean, he has taught him well. I'll give Tim Zbyszko everything for his athletic ability, for his wrestling talent. He's got all the tools necessary to be a big star in this business, but he might want to change that attitude of his. Sticking with somebody like Justin Michaels, I don't know.
Yeah, you can't take shortcuts or anything to get to where you a title is or fame and glamour. Yeah, that comes naturally if you got the talent.
Man. Rage cutting off the momentum of Tim Zbyszko there with his knees. Throw him back off here. Maybe a quick sunset flip there. The action, fast and furious in this junior title three-way.
We've been over.
Oh, wow.
Hot shot him right on.
Hot shot him. Man, that is right. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if he can get a pinfall here if we would roll Rage back in, but
maybe he feels more confident getting a pin on Cruz.
Maybe. As we can say, both these men are in the ring right now. Not the champion, but one of them could easily become the champion right now here, AP, if they were to get a quick pin on one another.
Rage, look at that, he's still out.
He's got to be careful. Wait, he's got to be careful there. Man, Mike Cruz almost picked up the title there.
Like you said earlier, Rage could be on the outside and still lose the title.
One fall to a finish, folks. It could come just like that. Quick pin or quick submission. This one's going to be over.
Rage slowly. He's slowly getting back up into the ring. Here he comes.
Man, he's going to go right after Mike Cruz with those right hands. He's not done with him by a long shot.
Here we go. He's going to go for the pin.
Go for a quick backslide. Go for a quick pin here. He was able to get that shoulder up.
Zbyszko
was just... Look at another inside cradle. Oh, we got it. Tim able to break it up. Nice ring presence there from Zbyszko, breaking up that pin. Again, it's not an elimination. One fall to a finish.
There goes Rage.
Oh, wow. That's almost like something Mike Cruz would throw with that huge enziguri.
Zbyszko just caught Blain Rage coming back over that rope.
Man, he just muscled him right over to the outside. And once again, it's back to the two contenders. Cruz and Zbyszko. Man, that's old school power there at suplex.
I remember the old days watching Davey Boy Smith do that. Just hold him up there.
Zbyszko, get over that cover. We have a new champion there.
Cruz kicked out just in the nick of time, too.
Choke him out here. See the voice looking on intently.
Absolutely. His new protege, if he could score that junior heavyweight title, what a feather in the cap for both of
them. Of course. Look like manager champions. Wherever you go. Because he has enough confidence in the abilities of Tim Zbyszko to maybe pick up this title here.
Wow.
Man, a big, big back suplex. Don't underestimate the power of Mike Cruz. The man's very strong, very quick. He's got all the tools necessary to be a giant, giant star in this business.
Absolutely. Last couple times, I've always said, pound for pound, he's probably the best or one of the best in the business.
Maybe the best athlete, absolutely, in the Southeast. And despite his attitude, I enjoy watching this guy work.
Every time.
He is going to be a big star someday. And he definitely wants to get that junior heavyweight title around his waist.
Oh, look at that. We got Rage going to the top rope. Cruz saw him up the top, minute.
Man. Takes them both down with that drop kick.
Michael cannot believe what's going on.
Looking concerned on his face. His boy's in trouble.
As well, he should be concerned.
He's going to be the first back to the feet here. Looks like he's going to be the champion.
The Rage has been. This is
who's he going to go after?
Show.
Is he going to go after Cruz? Is he going to go after Zbyszko? It's a shot to Cruz, shot to Zbyszko.
Back and forth. It's like ping pong.
Bam, bam.
Oh,
bam.
Nice clothesline.
Another one.
Oh, face shot with that double chop. Well, like I'm saying, this is his third show as junior heavyweight champion, so he knows what it's about.
A shot right to the gut. Cruz here, about toe hold. Hey, look out, keep your eye on Cruz.
We got him in the gut. Whoa, what's he doing?
What's going on here?
He still has Zbyszko.
Suplex. He's got them both. Two. No.
That was incredible. He had Zbyszko tied up with the legs, and he pulled Cruz over in
the
suplex.
And the fisherman suplex. Yeah, he hooked the leg and almost got a three count. Oh, is that a shot to the throat? Yeah, absolutely.
Ropes.
Man, nice knee to the chin there.
Cruz
the cover.
Amazed. Oh, it breaks up the pin.
Caught it just in time. That could have been a three count. Got to wonder if at some point Michaels might get involved in this matchup if he feels like Zbyszko's about to lose it.
Yeah, you would think he would try to, but I don't think he wants to take that title shot away from him. But then again, there's no disqualification, correct?
Theoretically, yes, but, you know.
We'll keep our eyes on him, man.
He's up on the top, man. Hung up right on that top rope. Here comes Rage. We've seen this before. Running start. Punts him.
Caught him right in the bread basket. Always put him up to the roof of the armory.
Usually he follows up with that hurricanrana. He might do just that. And it might be enough to put away Cruz if he can get it. Wait a minute, keep your eye on Zbyszko. Again, that those three-way rules.
Uh-oh. What is going on here?
On top. Maybe a double superplex of some kind? No. Zbyszko, look at him laid out in the middle of the ring. And here comes Rage off the top. He hits Zbyszko on the way down. Michaels can't believe it.
He used Cruz to hit Zbyszko. He's going for
a
double pin.
Pin on both men. Two. Both men kick out. Not quite enough.
Wow. Michaels.
Look of relief on the voice's face says it all. His boys are in trouble. The champion, despite the three-way rules, is in full control here.
A lot of credit to go to Blain Rage right here for handling both these two top competitors.
He keeps it up with maybe whatever he hits right now. Oh, wait a minute, look at that's what we were talking about.
It was just a matter of time, I bet.
Zbyszko, a stunner, puts out Rage.
This could be it.
It's a cover.
We could have a new champion.
Oh, and a kick out. But you saw that nice ring presence there, clearing him away from the ropes. Michaels thought it was a three count. Look at him just get frustrated, just laying those fists. Just taunting Rage. He's going to try to finish him. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Looking for plane damage. Got it.
That's his finisher.
It's over. It's over.
Wait a minute.
Michaels again.
Oh, he's distracting the
referee. This man just got hit. Come on now. Oh, there's a shot.
There goes Michaels.
Rage just had it up. Wait a minute. There goes Rage. Oh, my goodness. No, no. Mike's gonna get it! Oh, we got a new champion!
Are you kidding? What presence of mind by Cruz.
Oh no. We have a new champion, folks. Blain Rage just lost the title without getting pinned. We've got a new junior heavyweight champion, excuse me. The real deal, Mike Cruz. Rage doesn't know what happened there.
You got Michael still out on the floor, Rage looking on, but Cruz has the title.
He is officially the champion now. He gets that belt and Rage can't believe it.
Man, can you believe that, AP? Blain Rage just lost his title without even being pinned.
It just goes to show you, a triple threat match can be very, very dangerous. And speaking of dangers, how about Tim Zbyszko just turning his back on the entire crowd and joining with Justin Martins?
Yeah, I have no idea what's going on with Tim Zbyszko, just spitting in the fans' faces. But speaking of disrespectful, you know, we saw at the intro of the show, the Circle of Disrespect had harsh words for Jesse Neal. He got very fired up. It's time for him to get his hands on the COD. The big tag team title match, Jesse Neal, QT Marshall, taking on the Circle of Disrespect. Titles are on the line.
Tag team titles are on the line here at USWA, and this one is getting very, very heated very quickly. We've got the Circle of Disrespect, the tag team champions, take on the impromptu team of Jesse Neal and QT Marshall.
You heard the powerful words of Jesse Neal earlier, and that led to this match.
A little content that was not too family friendly, if we may say so ourselves, AP, that we could not air. This one got very, very personal. And Jesse Neal, he's not playing around here, AP. I think he really wants out to hurt the Circle of Disrespect at this point.
Yeah, it's unbelievable that this could be Jesse's last time here.
I don't know what's going on with Jesse Neal. He is, man, look at him, just right hands on Simon Says. He's not playing around here. Here he goes after Francisco Ciatso, the partner. He's just going to beat down both of these men.
QT trying to help.
QT trying to restrain him.
A lot of emotions in this one.
You see Jesse Neal talk about possibly retiring from the business, quitting the business. We don't know what's going through the head of Jesse Neal lately, but I don't know if he's going to be able to really focus on this matchup. I don't know if QT is going to be able to rein him in and get him to maybe fight for these titles. I have no idea what's going to happen here, AB.
If this is his last USWA match and they win the titles,
what's going to happen? Yeah, I don't know. He very well could win the titles here. He has the ability. He's got a great partner with QT Marshall, the Ring of Honor star. But I don't know if in the head that Jesse's at right now, the place where he's at, I don't know if he's going to be able to really form a cohesive tag team with QT. I mean, they're going against the Circle of Disrespect, two-time tag champions here in USWA, won belts all over the place, one of the best tag teams around. They've got to focus here, though. He can't let his emotions get away from him, I think.
Yeah, and you see them taking full advantage of Jesse Neal being in the corner, stomping on his throat, distracting the referee.
Here's a tag in to the King of Florida, Francisco Ciatso, and they cut off Jesse Neal early. I mean, they're just going to put him to work on the side of the ring.
Taunting QT. This is their game, though. This is how they work.
This is absolutely how they work.
That's why they're the best.
Won the titles, kept the titles, and just laid waste to every tag team that's been put in front of them. Look at that shot on QT Marshall.
Stomps him right in the head, too.
As you see, folks, this one got so emotional that Frank Howell said he was going to ref this one personally.
Yeah, he went to oversee everything on this one.
This very well could be the last time Frank sees Jesse Neal in a USWA ring. I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but I mean, he's got such a connection with Jesse. They've been very good friends. He's got a connection with his fans here at the Armory.
Makes a tag.
And wait, there's a tag into QT.
Wow, did you hear that?
Fire under QT.
Wow, what a beautiful dropkick.
He's got a great opportunity
here
to score a tag team title belt. Regardless of where Jesse's at or not, he's going to take advantage.
Oh, yeah.
Great athlete. Oh, yeah, he's got a cover, too.
I mean, you can see the focus on QT as soon as he got in the ring.
QT, I mean, he's a Ring of Honor star. He's a
look at this. Look at this.
The independent man, yeah. And I don't know if he's going to be able to overtake both the members of the Circle. Oh, wow. Man, a Sez Express clothesline.
That usually ends the matches right there.
Absolutely, man. Look at the ring presence, though, of Marshall, that veteran ring presence, getting out of the ring so he couldn't lose the match. On pure instinct.
Watch out, we got Francisco on the outside. The
King of Florida is going to be trying to put him back in. Oh, look at it, getting hot and heavy in there with Frank the Tank. So he's going to put up with any nonsense this one. I think he's also just tired of the Circle of Disrespect just stealing one match after another here, AP.
Yeah, he wants to make sure the law is laid down the correct way. Not that there's anything wrong with the other officials. They just got over on it a little bit.
Count on QT here. Jesse Neal, man, he just... I don't know if he really even cares about the titles. I think he just wants to to put the boots to the circle for absolutely disrespecting him and his family.
Yeah, I understand where he's coming from with that, but you also, when you're in that ring, you got to focus. Don't let your emotions take over.
There's a cover on QT. QT able to muscle out. Man, he is taking a beating, though, at the hands of the COD.
Jesse wants in bad.
Tag into Florida.
That's what they do best.
One of the best tag teams in the business today for just getting things done. It's a double elbow. Quick cover. Kick out from Marshall.
Jesse tried coming in for the save. QT got out of there just in time.
I mean, this could be a deciding factor, is the fact that, you know, Jesse Neal and QT are not a tag team together. You know, the COD, they know each other inside and out. They know how to cut off that ring. They know how to get victories. I mean, don't count on – I mean, I'm not counting out Jesse Neal and QT.
They're
great singles competitors. I mean, they're great competitors in their own, but they're not a cohesive tag team.
They've been together as long as this match started.
Absolutely, about 5-10 minutes maybe.
Well, you got the COD who have been around for years together. Around Florida, around all the southern states, up to the northeast.
Jesse Neal wants in really, really badly, but he's got to make that tag. Get that tag for QT. Here's QT fighting back with those right hands. Those big, powerful right hands.
Down.
Oh, that cuts him off with that boot right to the head.
At least resorting to the name calling, psychology-wise. That's what Simon does.
Only two count there on Marshall. Simon with a nerve pinch, trying to make QT pass out here in the middle of that ring. Frank Howell checking on him.
He passes out, it's just as good as giving up.
As good as, absolutely, the mission should be over.
Crowd slowly getting behind him.
QT again with those big, powerful right hands. Man,
wow.
Chop right to the back of that cutoff.
Oh,
spits right in the face of QT Marshall.
Disrespecting.
Well, living up to their name, AP. Absolutely.
Yep.
Big elbows, but
trying to fight out of that corner. But... Oh, there goes Francisco.
Again, going after Jesse Neal. And here comes the Dog of War trying to get back in there, but Frank Howell's going to cut him off. He's got to make a tag.
Yeah, that totally worked in the COD's favor. They got Jesse hot. Tried coming in. Frank was distracted. And there goes Ciatso pulling some breaking of the eyes or nose or face of some sort on QT.
I want the pizza. Here comes QT. He's going to get a roll up with a sunset flip.
Oh,
a nice counter there from Ciatso. That knee to the face. And again, cuts right back off QT. Put it back out for a quick cover. Two. Neal was ready to make the save.
Yeah, he was ready to jump in on it. QT had the whereabouts there to pick out again.
Just gonna wear him down with that sleeper hold. Neal's trying to get the crowd behind QT Marshall, trying to get over there and make a tag. He wants in.
He's gotta fire up. He's gotta get that tag.
Come on, give him those elbows. Ropes.
Oh
man, another elbow right to the chin.
Just needed a quick wall.
Oh, kick right to the back. Puts him right back down again. QT unable to really mount any momentum here to get that tag.
He's trying to wear him down now. That's one way you can do it. Just cut off that circulation. Look at that. Referee's got to get under there. He's got it on the throat.
QT maybe.
Oh,
there's a bite.
Oh, that's one way to get out of it.
Gonna tag it to the Emerald Emperor, Simon Says. Double team here. He's gonna give him a five count. Kick Says. Oh! Went for the enziguri on Ciatso and caught Simon Says right in the temple. Kicks off Ciatso, could be going for a tag. And he gets
there
it.
There it is. He's got just a dog of war.
Off the top. Takes out both men with a drop kick. He is firing up on the circle of disrespect.
One down, the other down. One
the
down,
one
the other
man
down.
Army. Off the top row. Here's the cover to Sez.
Oh, he caught his own guy.
This could be the opportunity Neal needs. Front drop kick to Ciatso. Up and a down.
Wow. Drove him down. Here goes one, two.
Oh, Ciatso at the very last second.
We almost had new tag team champions.
But again, new tag team champions, what's going to happen to the belts if they win? I guess I'm not worried about that right now, but Neal's definitely got a chance here to put away Sez and Ciatso. Maybe he can try a little teamwork with QT here. Bring it to the top. Gonna count it off.
There we go.
Oh no, there's that. And instead of going for the punch, he just bites. Double knocker, man.
That's exactly what I was gonna say.
But they were right in. They were in position here to take those tag titles.
Oh,
wait a minute.
Look at that.
Neal knocked out QT.
That was by accident, though, I think.
Oh, is that a low blow? Sez is going to get the cover. Oh, doesn't get it. Fortunately, Neal was able to kick out of that one.
I believe Simon kicked Jesse Neal and accidentally hit QT.
Some kind of collision there, absolutely. Some kind of miscommunication. Simon says he's going to square up Jesse Neal right here.
He's still reeling from that low blow from Simon Sez.
Full head of steam. Cuts him off in the knee.
Oh, super kick.
Spear. We're going to have new champions.
Here we go. One, two.
Oh, no.
Ciatso with the save.
I could have sworn we were going to have new champions there. Ciatso, like a little spider monkey, is just getting right across the ring and saving it. Oh, the shot with that briefcase. Knocks out QT.
Marshall's out.
He is out.
Look at that. Frank, you can't let this.
Gotta stop this, Frank. They're going to try to use that briefcase again. Swing and a miss. Drop kick.
Barely
able to
caught
cut
him,
off Ciatso.
He barely got him, but it was enough. That thing bounced back on his head. Whoa,
there's another
low.
There's another.
Oh, he's got the tights.
The tights. Three, that's it.
Oh, are you kidding?
The COD escape again. Jesse Neal unable to take those titles and unable to get retribution.
Crowd for Jesse Neal, which is probably his last match here.
Could very well be his last match. We've heard him say such a thing. QT trying to raise Jesse Neal's hand. Crowd giving him respect. Oh, wait a minute, look out!
Oh, are you kidding? What was that for?
QT turning on Jesse Neal, I guess because he failed him and not being able to win those titles. QT wanting the spotlight all for himself.
How unprofessional.
Thank you.